kids, how y'all doing today? Now, for you, for those of y'all who don't know me, my name is Craig, and I'm on YouTube. This is Welcome to Heartbreak Dog, or HRTBRKD0G. Today I'm doing a new series called, well, it's not really a new series, just something I just felt like doing. Today I'm going to be talking about gun control. Have a question for all y'all. Do we really need gun control? Well, this has been an issue, if not for the more recent shooting incidents like the Sandy Hook thing, the Arizona Mall. I mean, I'm serious. Do we really need gun control? Now, personally, I think the government, for the people who say that the government is going to take all the guns and then slaughter all the people like in, what was it, Libya or Syria like that, for one, that won't happen. Just like, if you recall in 2012, there was that PIPA and SOPA Act. And we all saw how everybody rose up against the idea once it became nationwide known. So, just like PIPA and SOPA, the government's not gonna take our guns. However, with that said, I do believe that gun control pretty much in this country is utterly failed. Just like the war on drugs. And much like the war on crime, pretty much. Now, none of this other stuff I'm doing right now is not scripted. I didn't write any of my scripts. I didn't memorize any special lines or nothing. This is all just going off the top of my head. So, but really, are guns really that bad? I mean, it's just like, I mean, personally, I like guns. I really like them. Now, I don't think we need gun control, personally. Now, I think I'm going to quote Chris Rock on this saying, we don't need gun control, we need bullet control. Because if you actually think about it, it makes sense. If, for example, a 9mm bullet costs, one bullet costs $10, and you had I don't know how many rounds I'm going to a 9mm. So, you had about, say, 9 shots in a pistol. You have $90 right there. So, I would think that, you know, we would have more control over stuff like this if the price of bullets were raised. Now, I can also see some people's arguments saying, but if we raise the price of bullets, who's to stop the government? Because then more people would be robbing people to steal the guns then. Now, I'm not saying the gun prices need to go up. I'm saying bullet prices need to go up. Now, I will agree with what some of the comments people are saying that, yes, we should. I mean, because I know the Second Amendment, the right to bear arms. And I like that. I agree with that. However, I don't think the right to bear arms includes assault rifles. But, hey, I'm not gonna argue with anyone on that. Personally, for me, I prefer an AK-47. Now, I've never fired an actual gun myself. I fired BB guns. So I wouldn't really know what an AK-47, well, actually, I do know what one sounds like. That was a bad childhood experience. But that's besides the point. Gun control. We need it, but we don't need it, pretty much. Because criminals don't care about gun control, because they already have a gun, and they already have the mindset of what to do with the gun. Because a criminal would know, or usually know, if they're going to or not going to kill someone. Now, I believe that, yes, after the Sandy Hook thing, I believe that, you know, they there should be more security around, like, schools and colleges and stuff. I mean, there should be. But that's probably not going to work out. Just because with the if factor, which I hate the if factor. It's like, if we have all these security guards there, who to say if one day all the security guards become violently ill due to a very, 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 very well planned out attack to take out the security guards, then come in and shoot the place. Now this is just off the top of my head, just like way, way out there, but it's the sad part is it's a possibility. Now, the thing is that with gun control, we need it, but we don't want it. I mean, example, look at, pretty much, just look at the U.S. as itself. Guns are sold just about everywhere. You can get guns at Walmart. Again, I know I'm quoting Chris Rock again, but still, he did comedy points are made. Guns in this country are readily available. Now, I think, if anything, I think the world would be better off if we went back to something like the Wild Wild West. Well, it'd be good and bad, pretty much. A cowboy with an assault rifle. Imagine that. But still, gun control, we need it, but I think the people need to actually take charge of it. And as far as the war on drugs and stuff, and war on guns, F out of here has failed, pretty much. That's all done failed. Because, honestly, just so everyone knows, the government truly does not care about the people in the nation. The only thing the government cares about is money, expanding the reach around the world, and itself, pretty much self-maintenance. And I know about the quote another comedian or something, maybe it might be the same one, but with every war that's been, every war the U.S. has been in, we've dropped, not deployments, but like our own stations there, just in case that country starts to get out of line. However, we as a country don't have the right to be there in the first place, especially if they don't want us there. So that's a contradiction in the U.S. So the U.S. trying to be the big brother, but yet here's the thing though. Somewhere in Africa, there's been a civil war ongoing for the past 60, 30 years. But yet, the U.S. has done nothing about it, nor even announced it, because there's no oil in it. Now, keep in mind all the countries, well, the more current countries the U.S. has been occupying, like Iraq, Iran, all over the Middle East, because they're the oil dominant. But yet, in Africa, somewhere in a village, where there's been a civil war going on, the U.S. has said nothing, they don't acknowledge it, they don't care because there's no money in it. What do you think this country is built on? Money. And to those who say, no, it's not, the country's built on hopes and dreams, you're an ignorant fool, I'll tell you that much. Yes, it's always been someone's dream to just be rich and happy, but no. Once you get rich, you want power. Once you have power, you want everything. Oh, I'm gonna check the time real quick. Alright. I'll speak for a little bit more. I might do a second video like this. This might be the only video I ever do like this on my channel ever again. But pretty much, the government doesn't care. It's all about power. And the last thing is about religion. Because religion is power. Now, to the atheists and the people who don't believe in, like, religion or Christianity and all that, hear me out. Every religious war has been over power. Now, if I'm wrong, look in the history books. Look now. Because last I checked, somewhere in Israel, they're fighting over, what was it, being Jewish or something like that? Now, being Jewish and hating them because you think they're weak, it's all about the same thing, man. Religion equals power. Power controls the people. Money comes from the people and the nation to give to the power so it can keep its control over the people. Now, obviously, this from the normal human standpoint or citizen standpoint, it sounds completely crazy and insane. This black guy doesn't know what he's talking about. He's an idiot. If you call me insane, then how about you stop looking at your iPod, whatever the thing it is that you apparently want to pay and wait in line for about a week just about the same thing over and over again. Is that not insane? So you better wait in line every year to buy the same thing that's either bigger or smaller and claims to be better. Okay, yeah, I'm crazy. I'm insane. But to conclude, everyone, it's pretty much all about power, money, and control. Whoever has that will want everything. If you think I'm lying, look in the history books. Because history will repeat itself when the people do not learn. So that's all I'm going to say for this video. Thanks for watching. My friend Greg over there is chilling out. He's filming this pretty much. And pretty much, I was never here. I'm sure I wasn't. Goodbye.